Secretary of the U.S. Air Force, Frank Kendall, along with Assistant Secretary of the Air Force for Acquisition, Technology and Logistics, Andrew Hunter, has provided important insights on the U.S. Air Force's plan in a keynote address at the 2023 Air and Space Forces Association's Warfare Symposium in Aurora, Colorado. Significant details have been revealed related to NGAD, or Next Generation Air Dominance Platform, and CCA, or Collaborative Combat Aircraft. Kendall stated U.S. Air Force leadership has recently given our planners a nominal quantity of collaborative combat aircraft to assume for planning purposes. The planning assumption is 1,000 CCAs. He explained, "This figure was derived from an assumed 2 CCAs for each of 200 NGAD platforms, and an additional 2 for each of 300 F-35s, for a total of 1,000. This is the first time the service has given a real sense of the scope and scale of its plans for these 2 future aircraft types." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why U.S. Air Force will keep dominating the skies. Let's get into the details. NGAD is essentially a 6th-generation fighter, the successor of F-22 Raptor, that will feature state-of-the-art stealth characteristics, optionally unmanned capability with AI-controlled missions, the ability to control a swarm of drones, greater battlefield data fusion, more powerful sensors, greater electrical power generation to equip directed energy weapons, a virtual cockpit helmet-mounted display allowing the pilot 360-degree vision, etc. NGAD is currently under development. Regarding NGAD, Kendall said in his speech, "The DAF, Department of the Air Force, is moving forward with a family of systems for the next generation of air dominance. That will include both an NGAD platform and the introduction of uncrewed collaborative aircraft to provide affordable mass and dramatically increased cost-effectiveness." It's important to note that the Air Force's plan to acquire 200 NGAD combat jets is comparable in size to its existing fleet of F-22 Raptor stealth fighters. Furthermore, we're aware that F-22s are being employed to aid in the development of the NGAD. Kendall stated regarding the 1,000 CCAs, "This isn't an inventory objective, but a planning assumption to use for analysis on things such as basing, organizational structures training, range requirements, and sustainment concepts," Kendall added in his keynote speech. "The figures are somewhat arbitrary, but we put that on the table as a way to basically structure that around what we think is a reasonable first tranche, reasonable ratio." He elaborated at the roundtable, "We'll learn as we go." Providing a sense of the overall scope of the CCA initiative, the discussion currently centers around a fleet of 1,000 drones. To put this into perspective, such a fleet would surpass the combined number of the Air Force's F-22 Raptor stealth fighters, F-15E Strike Eagle combat jets, and A-10 Warthog ground attack aircraft. In his speech, Kendall specifically referenced the NGAD combat jet and the stealthy F-35 Joint Strike Fighters, implying that the Air Force anticipates the CCAs to function cooperatively with these combat aircrafts, at least in the beginning. It's plausible that CCAs, or other advanced drones developed independently, could still be paired with non-stealthy aircraft, such as older fighters, as well as support platforms like tankers and airlifters to enhance their capabilities significantly. During the roundtable, Kendall touched on the possibility of integrating CCAs with B-21 Raider stealth bombers. He said that the Air Force looked into something like this and that something with comparable range and meaningful payload that would go with B-21 didn't turn out to look very cost-effective. We do know, in this context, that Rader will have a massive range. He said that there might be ways in which the CCAs could be coupled with B-21s, although they'd have to be forward-based some degree to do that. He explained, "We're shooting for a CCA to be a fraction of the cost of an F-35. One of my motivators in initiating the CCA program was the affordability of the Air Force." Kendall continued by saying that the Air Force would become unaffordable if it continued to only buy current generation aircraft like the F-35A and F-15EX, as well as future NGAD combat jets, and that CCAs will offer additional affordable mass. He added that, "If we ask for too much of the CCAs, we're going to get bogged down trying to get what we need, and that the drones didn't need to be gold-plated to provide important additional operational advantages." Kendall said in his address, "One way to think of CCAs is as remotely controlled versions of the targeting pods, electronic warfare pods, or weapons now carried under the wings of our crewed aircraft. CCA will dramatically improve the performance of our crewed aircraft and significantly reduce the risk to our pilots." None of the main rivals of the US, Russia, and China has actually been able to operationally deploy fifth-generation fighters. Also, the so-called fifth-generation fighter, Russian Su-57 and Chinese J-20, cannot be categorized as true fifth-generation aircraft since they have several fundamental flaws, like poor stealth characteristics. When it comes to uncrewed platforms, too, the US has an edge. The US has come a long way since Predator, which ushered in the drone age. Predators were best known for their ability to deliver precision strikes as their controllers sat halfway around the world in small and discreet bunkers. The US is already deploying MQ-25 refueling drones on its supercarriers and developing an array of new age platforms that will work together with manned systems. Skyborg and the Associated Autonomous Aircraft Experimentation AAX testing campaign has been moving smoothly on the development of artificial intelligence AI-driven computer brain and related systems designed to provide advanced autonomous capabilities to various types of aircraft. While drones are being developed by many countries, no other nation comes close to this type of integration in the Air Force. It's evident that the planning, coupled with a massive budget, will keep the service well ahead in the foreseeable future. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.